You've had a really interesting summer.
I've had such a big summer. It's been a big summer.
It really has, right?
Yeah.
Just life-changing.
Yeah, it has been life-changing. I've met a lot of people. I've seen a lot of things. I spent the last 2.5 months in an RV, which was kind of radical, living in an RV, which I've never done before.
I want to talk to you about this because I've never done RV, and I'm very interested in doing this, and maybe... maybe like a life change and just living in an RV. But I am interested in that or an Airstream. This is an RV.
This is like a proper... Okay, so basically we started this caravan across the country, the DNC, and got like 500 people to join. It was really groovy, but I was like, hey, Mom, can I borrow our 17-year-old motorhome for a week to do this adventure? And she was like, yeah, of course. That week turned into a two and a half month road trip of sorts. We still have her RV, actually.
You really
I haven't given it back.
Look at how cool you look driving. The peace train right there, yeah.
It rained a little and got the peace train part kind of got a little droopy.
How many people were in the RV? How many people can you fit in an RV? How big is
the
RV?
Well, I mean, you can fit as shoulder to shoulder if you wanted to. Comfortably,
like
how many people
like a clown
can you fit?
Car? It's like 400 people we fit.
I think at most we had maybe 9 people in it or 10 people in it once, and the least there was, at minimum, there was always 4 of us. But you get to know someone really well when you're living in tight quarters like
that. You really
that.
Do, yeah.
With no shower. It's a little complicated.
Where do you go to the campsites? Interested in this.
You can literally go anywhere in an RV. So I grew up camping in an RV, so I was very comfortable with it. But some of my friends who I was with to start, if I were on night shift and they woke up at, let's say, 3 a.m. when I parked somewhere, and they're like, where are we? And I'm like, oh, we're just on the side of the road. Like, what do you mean we're on the side of the road?
Yeah.
Like, oh, just look out the window. And you could just find, like, a dirt patch on the side of the freeway and pull over. You can sleep there. You can sleep in a Walmart parking lot. We slept in Union Station
in D.C. A Walmart parking
lot?
What do you mean? You can just park in a Walmart?
Yeah, you can park in a Walmart. Truck
really?
Stops. Yeah, the whole shebang.
Is that legal?
You get to meet
Does
cool
Walmart
people?
Let you do that?
Well, I mean, I've never asked. Hey, Walmart, can I park in? Is that okay?
Do you see other RVs when you go there?
Oh, yeah. Every Walmart will generally have an RV or a cargo van in its parking lot at night.
That's fascinating. You know,
Check it out.
When we did, I was doing shows in different colleges around the country, and because I know Walmart is amazing, but New York City.
Is it?
Yeah, I love all that stuff. Kmart, Walmart, any mart. Yeah. Yeah, I'm in. I'm fascinated by those giant stores.
They are giant.
I was asking
their parking lots,
these kids
out.
After this college thing, I go, where do you hang out? Do you guys go to like, usually like the Ratskeller or something, or some name of like a bar that all these kids, and they go, we go to Walmart. I go, you hang out at Walmart?
Wait, where is this?
And like in the middle of the country somewhere. Yeah. I mean, but it wasn't the first time
that
I've heard this. A lot of kids do this.
A lot of communities that I hadn't experienced, because I grew up in L.A., so I didn't know this, but a lot of communities, really, Walmarts are kind of the center of the community. They depend on Walmart for food, for clothing, for everything.
Yeah.
It's like their superstore.
And then you can just park there and just hang out there forever.
I thought Costco was big, but Walmart is like 5 Costcos in one.
I've never been to a Costco.
What?
I know.
Costco's
really?
The best.
I know. Well, calm down. I mean, but I don't know if I would want. Why would I want to go to a Costco?
Because you can get everything super, and it lasts so much longer, and it's so much cheaper.
Yeah, you know, I don't want too much of anything.
Okay, that's fair. I'm a minimalist.
My mom and dad, I think they went to a Costco once, and it was like they were preparing for the end of the world. I was like, we had so many paper towels.
Yeah,
it was almost like a corn maze through my house to get to. Like, I go, this is too many paper towels. It was just stacked.
But you save so much money. I guess I'm all about Costco. And they treat their employees really well. I just think Costco's a cool company.
All right, but I'll have to check it out. I mean, I'm not sure what I get there, but I think my mom got a giant thing of ketchup.
They have giant.
And I go, are we starting a carnival? What's going on? Why would we? Between you and dad. And we started a carnival,
How was it?
My dad is P.T. Barnum. It's very famous. We made a lot of money. What a life I've had.
It all makes sense.
It all makes sense, and I'm a clown, We currently drive around an RV, me and my family. There's 500 people in my family.